chances are you might have heard a pastor, a conference speaker talk about how women neurotically compare themselves to each other. And she probably urged you to stop doing that, that you're awesome the way you are, and don't just give in to this place where you're so insecure that you're constantly comparing yourself. All right, but I want to give you a slightly different take on this, because boy, we do drive ourselves nuts, don't we, with this whole comparison thing. Well, as I was pondering this with God, and I thought for sure he would just reassure me that you're awesome the way you are, Debbie, you don't need to be comparing yourself to anybody else, I've made you unique and all of that, which you've probably heard 100 times before. As I was actually pondering this thing where we do compare ourselves with other women, I felt like God actually convicted my heart and said, what are you really doing, Debbie, when you're comparing yourself to other women? Why are you doing that? And I was really convicted. The Holy Spirit showed me that it comes from a place of pride. Yes, pride. I want people to view me as a good enough mom, a great wife, a lovely Christian woman. It's really a pride thing. Yes, mixed with insecurity, but a lot of that is still coming back to, I want people to like me, to approve of me, to say, wow, look at her. She's a fantastic gardener, a fantastic homemaker, a fantastic mom, a fantastic wife. And that's really a pride thing. And you know, God is not really big on us having a lot of pride. He has a lot to say in the Bible about how he does not appreciate pride in people. In fact, he condemns pride in people. In fact, that's one of the things he hates, is prideful, haughty people. Ooh, okay. So maybe I need to stop. As soon as these insecure thoughts come in and I start to compare myself to other women, maybe I need to stop right there and say, wait a minute, I'm not going to dwell on these thoughts because these are prideful thoughts. And instead, I'm going to direct my attention to the Lord. You know, in Colossians 3, he says, don't set your mind and heart on earthly things. Set your heart on heavenly things. And so immediately in that moment, and here's what I'm asking you to do too, when those thoughts come in that I'm not good enough and I should be like that other woman, recognize that that's actually a prideful thought and immediately redirect your thoughts to heaven, to God, the one who is perfect, the one who we should adore. Let's maybe turn on a worship song in that moment. Some of my favorites are Waymaker by Leland, or I love this new song, Speak the Name by Corinne Hawthorne. Love that song. Or What a Beautiful Name by Hillsong. I could go on and on with all these songs that are really songs of adoration, of true worship of the Lord, who is the only perfect one, who is the only one who is good enough. Get my drift? So in those moments when you're tempted to just kind of have that neurotic, comparison business going on, in those moments, I'm urging you to just take that thought captive, and instead of dwelling on that, just say, Lord, I am so appreciative of who you are, that you are mighty, you are magnificent, you are majestic. I don't know why I'm using all the M words, but he is mighty, magnificent, and majestic. Lord, I'm so thankful that you are truly the author of hope, that you are filled with compassion and grace and mercy and kindness and love. I adore all that you are. Maybe in those moments when, again, we're tempted to start this comparison thing, we need to stop that thing in its tracks and say, I will not be dwelling on these prideful thoughts. Instead, I will choose to adore the one who is perfect.